We will now start with chapter 3, which is formalism of quantum mechanics and the introduction to quantum mechanics by E.J. Griffiths. The very first thing, which is not very explicitly mentioned in the Griffiths, but we will discuss them, is postulates of quantum mechanics. The postulates we have already done, but not explicitly we have mentioned them one by one. So today we will mention them one by one. And the postulates are actually statements which are mutually agreed and correct. So to prove a postulate, it's not possible, but based on the postulate, we can prove science and we can do some mathematical derivations. So the itself, the proof of postulate is not possible, but based on that postulates, we can develop some mathematics, and that is to be correct and mutually agreed. So the very first postulate of quantum mechanics is, let's say, postulate 1. And postulate 1 in quantum mechanics is that the state of a quantum mechanical system is described by a wave function, which we also call state function, and it will completely describe a function, and it is written as psi rt, where r is the three-dimensional space variable, which we can write as x, y, and z. And time is another variable, the time evolution of wave function. And then we write this in one dimension is psi x and t. When a wave function is independent of time, then we write is psi of x. And in one dimension, it is sufficient to write it is psi x and t. So the wave function and these wave function, in order to be a physically verifiable state or a physical state which exists, which can be measured, then we call them normalizable states. And the normalization condition is that integration from minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate rt and psi rt d, then we are having for psi x of t we will write dx, for this we will write dr, and now r is actually three dimensions are being multiplied, so we will write d tau, the volume element, and this will be equal to 1. This is the same condition which we write in one dimension is psi conjugate and psi, such that this is xt and this is also xt, and we write dx with it, and this is equal to 1. So this discusses the probability density of a wave function. This is the very first postulate of quantum mechanics, that a quantum mechanical system can be completely described by. Similarly, postulate 2. Postulate 2 of quantum mechanics is that physical quantities, that physical quantities in quantum mechanics, physical quantities in quantum mechanics we call is observables. And these observables corresponds in quantum mechanics, they correspond to linear and Hermitian operators. Means the physical quantities are no more physical quantities. In quantum mechanics, they are called observables, and these observables are linear and Hermitian operators. Means the observables in quantum mechanics are called operators, and these operators are linear and Hermitian. And we have discussed the Hermitian earlier, but we will do it here as well. That what are Hermitian operators, means what are their values. They will have linear, they will have real values, and no complex will be there. So in postulate 2, we say that physical quantities are called observables in quantum mechanics, and the observables are actually operators, and those operators will be linear and Hermitian if they are quantum mechanical operators. For example, we are having position operator, which we write a head over it. This is also in three dimension. We call the linear, we call the distance or the position operator. We are having the momentum operator. We are having the Hamiltonian operator, the angular momentum operator, and so on. Means we are having these as the operators. These are observables, like position is an observation and momentum is an observation or measurement. So these we call as operators or observables. So the observable are actually the physical quantities, as we discuss in classical mechanics. The third postulate is, the third postulate of quantum mechanics is that in any measurement of the observable which is associated with an operator, the only values that it will have will be called the eigenvalues, and they will satisfy the equation. For example, we will have an operator A, and it operates on a wave function, on the state of a system. It will generate an eigenvalue which we call A and psi. So these values, this operator is supposed to be linear and Hermitian. Then the eigenvalue that it will generate will be real eigenvalue, means the real number. And psi will be then called the eigenvector or the eigenfunction. So these psi's will be actually then normalizable, and they will serve as the basis of a Hilbert space. Because the wave function that we say, the wave function actually lives in Hilbert space like a vector lives in vector space. So psi will live in Hilbert space, and the basis of the Hilbert space are actually these psi's. So we will say that psi is a normalizable state of a function or a normalizable wave function. When an operator will act on it, when some measurement is done on this state of a system, the state of a system will remain the same, and it will generate this value. It will give this value So these size, any these will serve as the basis of the Hilbert space, which we can write as psi i's. So psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and so on, they will serve as the basis of Hilbert space. And any function, any wave function, let's say any wave function psi, can be expanded as a linear combination in terms of these psi's. So any wave function we can expand as a linear combination of these bases, just as we expand a vector in terms of the unit vectors. These psi i's, which we call the bases of Hilbert space, are like unit vectors in vector space. So this is the third postulate of quantum mechanics. The fourth postulate of quantum mechanics is the postulate 4 of quantum mechanics is postulate 4 is actually stating that if a system is described by a normalizable or a normalized wave function, then any measurement that we will do on the state of the system will be actually the average value of that measurement, which we call the expectation value. So if we are having a normalized state of a system represented by psi, and we want to measure the value of this operator or this physical quantity on this system, then this will be equal to the average value, which we call the expectation value of that observable, and this will be equal from minus infinity to plus infinity, and psi conjugate A psi and d tau. In one dimension we will write dx. So this will be the expectation value of the state of the system. Fifth is that postulate fifth says that the wave function is a function of position, means r and t, then it will evolve in time. This will evolve in time. The wave function will evolve in time, and it will satisfy the Schrödinger wave equation, which is the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation. Is this postulate says that it is described by a wave function, so this wave function will satisfy the time independent Schrödinger wave equation, which is h psi equals e psi, while the time evolution of this will satisfy the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation, which is h psi rt is equal to I h bar and curly psi over curly t. So this is the time evolution of the wave function. Now we will have to keep in mind that we are restricting ourselves to the Schrödinger picture of quantum mechanics. As we know that the very basic difference, now I will not go into much detail of the different pictures of quantum mechanics, but I will explain this thing in brief words. The Schrödinger's picture of quantum mechanics of quantum mechanics is that when in means the Schrödinger is actually talking about the time evolution of the wave function. Like the wave function will evolve in time, while the operator will remain static. Like sine of r will actually go to sine r t, while the operator, which is O, will remain the same. It will be equal in time. Means the wave function will evolve in time, but the operator will remain static in time. It will be O a time t0 and O a t will be the same. This is equality.